This video is proudly sponsored by NewType. Tools, accessories, model kits, these guys have it. Hop over to newtypeshq.com and use promo code UTALKABUTTER for 10% off on your next purchase. Hey, what's going on, my dudes and dudettes, and welcome back to another exciting build from the good folks from Bendai, Japan. So why don't we get started with the 160th scale, perfect grade, MSZ-006 Mobile Suit Zeta Gundam. From the anime series, Mobile Suit Zeta Gundam. And without further ado, let's get to it. Yo, what's going on, my dudes and dudettes, and welcome back to another exciting build from the good folks from Bendai. And if this is your first time to this YouTube channel, welcome. So just to reiterate, in 2020, I just want to take this time to say thank you guys for watching the videos and liking and sharing it. It definitely gave me something to really work on through that really stressful year. But most importantly, I want to give a huge shout out to my patrons. Thank you guys so much for investing into what we all love as a hobby, and definitely something that we can all share and relate to. So if you guys are one of my patrons, please leave a comment down below and give those guys a lot of love, because they are responsible for having us see the MSZ-006 Zeta Gundam. Now, when it comes to the Zeta model kit, I definitely have a great deal of experience of building this particular mobile suit, because I built the 2.0 Mastery a little bit a couple of months ago, and that kit was absolutely great. But the one thing that really kind of bugged me was I wasn't able to fully get it into the Wave Rider mode. So since this is a perfect grade and there's probably a great deal of cavity space and probably a great deal of real estate to hide the electrical wiring, I think I can actually pull it off in this particular build. Now, as you can clearly see on the box, you get two unique boxes that come with it. Some parts are going to house the actual mobile suit parts, other parts will actually house the Wave Rider, but there's also a little bit of hidden surprises inside this particular mobile suit, because just like any old school master grade or any kind of old school perfect grade, this kit is packed to the brim with a lot of old school micro Phillips head screwdrivers. Now, before we get into all that nitty gritty detail, we need to talk about the 3 instruction manual, because this is where it's really important. First one being your standard instruction manual, introducing you what you can expect for all the cool gimmicks of this particular perfect grade. Everything down to the LED lights, heads, open and close hatches to expose the inner frame, a slew of weapon accessories, which I believe is 2 beam sabers, a beam rifle, a shield, and I guess a grenade launcher and whatnot. And then probably by far the most selling part of this mobile suit is transforming it into the Wave Rider mode. Now, first experience transforming this mobile suit with the Master Grade was very, very difficult, because some of the parts either fell out or they just didn't kind of interlock correctly the way how they were supposed to. So I hope I can imagine with the Perfect Grade, I can help get some of those problems alleviated while at the same time improving what I learned from the Master Grade and implement it onto the Perfect Grade. As for the second to last page, gives you a complete guide to how to apply the sticker decals, while the lower right hand corner gives you a complete color guide to add some custom flair to this particular mobile suit. Now, this one's not gonna be too crazy for those who just wanna do a simplistic paint job, so I like the fact that the simplicity of it is actually quite enjoyable. But that's where the fun ends, because this is where things get very, very nuts. As you can clearly see here, if you guys are familiar with the Mach 2, this kit is actually implementing the same number system for everything to Phillips head screwdrivers, springs, a handful of metallic pieces that are actually designed to help complete a circuit to illuminate the LED lights that does come with this particular mobile suit, while at the same time giving a small selection of electrical wiring and a nice spread of sticker decals. Now, these sticker decals are not anything crazy that you would expect from a modern perfect grade, but they get the job done if you're just doing a straight up build, which I do find that very welcoming. But hey, if sticker decals aren't your thing, you are more than welcome to look on eBay and find some water slide decals for a reasonable price. Now, for the first runners, we're gonna get these beautiful spread of white pieces, which are nicely sculpted while giving some surface detail, not too crazy, but at the same time, just enough to give some nice detail. Nice, beautiful sculpt of the mask for the mobile suit. More inner frame of the outer part of the surface detail looks great. The inner frame detail for this particular mobile suit is just beautiful, which definitely encourages you to do some custom painting. The nice classic blue runners, which are absolutely always welcoming. A handful of like chrome-like pieces for the pistons and open exposed areas. Pre-molded hands that are actually manipulative enough, which looks really cool. A handful of clear bits for the eyes, camera module, as well as the wingtip sections for the mobile suit, which is great. Definitely encourages you to do some more customization. A nice cutout section for the eyes to actually add more emphasis to illuminate the eyes with LED lights. more white runner pieces, more sea blue pieces for the wingtip areas, and more runners in the far back. So it's pretty straightforward and not too crazy. Now this particular Mosa does come with two beam sabers, which I'm not going to be using a lot, but this is where things get kind of cool with this particular beam saber. When you open up box number two, it not only has probably by far the most boldest decisions I've seen for a particular perfect grade, but definitely by far the most coolest gimmick that I've seen yet, because I haven't seen this, not even on a perfect grade ever. Well, I mean, if you want to get very specific, you know, there is the perfect grade RX-78 Unleashed that has an LED-like gimmick, but this was like the first of its time that has never been implemented on a perfect grade and never was introduced to it after this, so I find this is actually very cool and very welcoming. Now, as for the instruction manual, they're very straightforward. One is give you a complete diagram on how to transform the Zeta Gundam into the Wave Rider mode, which I have to give Bandai a lot of love and credit for this. This is just bonkers. This would actually drive someone nuts when they build this for the first time. So it's nice that they actually took the time to show you how to construct it in the Wave Rider. Box number two, once again, more selected number pieces, once again, with springs, LED lights, and at the same time, more Phillips head screwdrivers, which, my goodness, this kid has a lot of them. More classic white runners, which are great for the legs because they look very extra thick. More interframe pieces for the actual part of the mobile suit. A handful of yellow runners, pardon me, I'm tired. And a handful of red runners for the feet and as for the head itself and the V fin. More interframe pieces, more sea blue pieces. As for the remaining runners, it's pretty straightforward. So there's not really anything new to really get into. So this kit is definitely a big issue for someone that's actually building their very first perfect grade. I mean, the perfect grade Evangelion, the RX-78, and then the other old school perfect grades, followed by the Wing Zero perfect grade, all implemented a function where you actually have to do some physical installation of Phillips head screwdrivers and electrical wiring to make things work. But this one, by far, my dudes and dudettes, is the hardest one. And I accept this challenge to do a custom build for you dudes and dudettes. So as always, before I get started, I need to evaluate which area I want to tackle first. Do I tackle the arms, do I tackle the legs, or do I tackle the head? Right now, I think the most reasonable area to tackle first is going to be the arms. They don't take as much time, and at the same time, they take little effort to put together. So what I'm basically going to do is cut these pieces out, sand down the nubs as best I can to get rid of those weird little bumps on the hands. But for the shoulders, this is where things I want to try to implement something really cool. I want to put some dots on here to implement areas that I want to drill into the surface so that I can sneak in two pico LED lights on each shoulder. So one's gonna be green and one's gonna be red. Pretty straightforward, but at the same time, very enjoyable to do.
I get so caught up in the middle, thinking of drowning in those blue eyes. I'm losing sight cause I am falling. I'm so deep down, deep down. And it's not a lie that I die. I can't hide. Tell me all of your lies. I will put out all of the fire if it gets too dark.
I used to be so low. Now I can't be alone. I used to be so, but I feel.
Now, this next part might seem a little bit too advanced, but at the same time, it's very easy to get done. So what I'm trying to basically do is put an LED light behind the thruster so that way it can illuminate it. So what I need to do is clear out this real estate by getting rid of these little pylons that are blocking my entrance of putting an LED light on top of that. And then once I get that cleared out, I'm gonna put four dots on specific key areas so that way I can cut out a triangular shape. Since the LED light is somewhat of a triangular shape, I wanna make sure that it's facing downwards so that way it can bounce the light through the vents and make it look kind of dynamic. But that's where it doesn't end there. To add a little bit more emphasis to that, I'm going to be adding like a nice wire mesh on top of that LED light so that way it has a nice dispersing effect. So that way you're not looking directly at the LED light where it's blinding you, but you get a nice little contextual texture that makes it look really neat looking. My dudes and dudettes, as this video is wrapping up, I want to share with you guys my thoughts and impressions about this model kit. So let's talk about the most difficult part about this model kit. The parts, okay? You would think it's the Wave Rider or the process of constructing this mold. No. It is the parts. So if you are not familiar with building a old school Wing Gundam Zero or a Mach 2 Gundam, or a RX-78 Gundam, or hell, why not the Perfect Great Evangelion Unit 1? You're gonna have a very, very difficult time putting this kit together because this is one kit that you can't knock out in a day or in a week. It will take weeks to get everything done and assembled. For me personally, it was definitely a big struggle because with the current circumstances right now, paint is at a premium right now. So find the right kind of blues and the right kind of yellows and metallic paints that really complement one another was definitely a big challenge, but at the same time was super exciting to really get into the nitty gritty detail because this particular Perfect Grade really, really encourages you to paint the inner frame. And I love that attention to detail, man. It definitely encourages you to break out of your comfort zone. I know I say this a lot, but it's true. The transforming gimmick, in my opinion, was not hard at all. In fact, I thought it was quite easy to implement the mobile suit into the Wave Rider mode and then put it back into Zeta. The instruction manuals are very well thought out to the point where you shouldn't have any issues doing that. And that was like my biggest fear when I built the Master Grade a couple months back. I did enjoy it, but it was definitely an issue where I felt like I was going to break something. Well, with the Perfect Grade, I don't get that kind of fear. But if there was one thing that I was kind of disappointed with this model kit was the Beam Saber LED light. Now, I know there's probably a handful of you dudes and dudettes that probably had zero problems. This happens to me a lot with Perfect Grades. When I put the LED light inside the actual compartment to illuminate the Beam Saber and put the battery in there that comes with the kit, turns out that the battery was dead. Don't know why that happened, but it is what it is. And I can't knock that out for Bendai. It's just one of those rare things that happens with this particular mobile suit. So when you do get this kit, make sure that it's fully operational. You shouldn't have any problems. The accessories themselves are quite cool. I have to give Bendai a lot of love and credit for just a small little gimmick with the beam rifle. If you bring down the viewfinder and then bring in the muzzle compartment inward, and then you hinge the swivel mechanic at the bottom, it disperses it in a way where it unlocks itself with a nice little screen animation. Love that! They didn't need to do that, and it works beautifully. And as for everything else, it's great. You know, I thought this was going to be an extremely difficult kit, but I think after spending years upon years building old school Perfect Grades from the Avan Unit 1, Wing Gundam, Mach 2 Gundam, and even the classic RX-79 Gundam, everything just kind of works in your head, if that makes any sense. You know, when you build yourself up to the point of building something that you're not familiar with, but at the same time you kind of are, kind of becomes easy for you. And this kit kind of delivered on that, man. Has that nice old school nostalgic vibe to it. Wasn't difficult to build, but definitely challenging because it did take me 2.5 weeks. But by far, this kit just encourages you to paint it. If you just buy it as is and just do a straight up build, that's not a problem. But I'm telling you, you guys are missing on something truly magical about this particular design. It's beautifully well engineered. These guys killed it having that transforming feature. On top of that, it's beautiful looking. Absolutely beauty and stunning. But definitely the downside with this particular mobile suit, it lacks dynamic poses because it doesn't have a front side-to-side crunch. You can't even swivel the waist left and right. It's static. And a lot of it has to do with the transforming gimmick. And it definitely makes sense why I see a lot of builders that have built a Zeta Gundam just kind of keep it in a static pre-pose. So if you're okay with that, this shouldn't be a problem for you guys purchasing it. For me, it was a problem at first, but at the same time, I respect all those builders that had to work what they had to work with, because you can't really do much with this particular perfect grade. So once you're done with it, put it in a nice shelf, give it to a close friend that probably can't build a mobile suit, you know, do them a favor, or hell, you know, make a video, show what you improved, show what you struggled, and show what you really enjoyed, like what I did. So overall, I can honestly tell you this kit is definitely worth the purchase. I loved it. And I can't stress this enough. I am so blessed that I have such a great community that really enjoys what I make, and at the same time are willing to take their own hard-earned money to actually help, like literally fund this project. So I have to say this again, you Patreons out there, thank you guys so much for making this project a reality. And if you are a Patreon, please leave a comment down below and share those people with a lot of thumbs up and likes and love. You know, they are responsible for this project become a reality, because it was very expensive to get, and at the same time, very time consuming to try to find the right time to buy it, because there's nowhere else you can buy it except for eBay. And we all know how crazy eBay is right now with the scalpers. So thank you, subscribers. Thank you, Patreons. And thank you for anyone that is new that came to this channel at the end of this month. You guys are awesome. And with that being said, I will see you dudes in the next video. And in advance, Happy New Year's to you all. And I want to wish all of you dudes and dudettes a happy and prosperous New Year's. But until then, catch you guys later.